Team Tropical Island back here. It's Dwayne, Jizzle, Jake, and Miss Kate. And we got another game. We got Jizzle against Kate again. Kate switched her deck up because the last one was that dragon deck. Takes a little bit of time. Jake's deck's a landfall deck. It's going to, you know, do the jizzle on people. So you gotta play fast against it. Speed monster, you know?
Right. What are you playing with over there, Kate?
I don't know.
That looks to me like some red deck wings or some goblins.
Who knows?
Which, your red deck wings does have goblins in it. I just don't think it's tribal based, is it?
It is not.
It's just damage based.
It's damage based. Yeah. It's more about killing you than...
Exactly. What the fuck else would you do with red deck wings?
Roll to see who goes first. Oh, 19. That landfall wants to play. Yeah. That landfall wants to go.
It hasn't been out in a while.
You haven't let him out in a while. He's taking a walk now.
Yeah. I haven't even got to touch any of the tokens yet. Oh, yeah, I can do that.
All right, we'll start us off, Jake. Let the people see what you got.
That's what I got in my hand.
Nice.
Yeah.
What do you got over there, Miss Kate? That's not bad. Mm-hmm. All right.
I play Forest and say go.
Forest and go. Draw, Kate.
Changes things a little bit. Do this instead. Rapid growth. Get myself a basic land, and that's your turn.
Draw.
Fire Dancer?
Oh, shit.
Yeah, whenever an instant or sorcery spell you control deals damage to an opponent, Satyr Fire Dancer deals that much damage to target creatures that player controls.
So if you hit Jake with a spell, you could also hit one of his creatures with that spell.
Nice. Okay.
Me cut my deck?
Go. Some mana boost up over there again. That fast old landfall.
If only I could search for a land right now. Undergrowth champion.
Ooh.
Actually, I'm going to take that back.
Alright.
I don't often take moves back.
Or, like I said, this is a learning channel. We want people to see, okay, no, I made that mistake. That's not a mistake you want to make.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
So I'll do this.
Plus, since I'm a pretty new player.
Yeah. There's things that you need to know, you know?
Mm-hmm. Hopefully that's not...
Jake's played long enough that he shouldn't take too much back. But yeah. That was a dumb move on his part.
Let's go.
He now knows it.
Yeah.
Okay. Alright. First thing first. It's a 3 mana. Let's see what we can do here. That's pretty cool. Keep going. What else? You got here. That's pretty good.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, I thought that one cost four.
There you go.
Chandra's Phoenix.
Okay.
So he's a flying haste, and whenever an opponent is dealt damage by an instant or sorcery spell you control, or by a planeswalker you control, return Chandra's Phoenix from your graveyard to your hand. So if she burns you, the Phoenix can come back. Mm-hmm. Pretty cool.
And it has haste on it.
No.
It does not have haste.
Yeah, it does have haste. It's just you don't want to tap, because you see that? He's got landfall. This is not going to be a 2-2 next turn. It is possibly going to be much larger. And your Phoenix can come back. So you gotta, you know?
Okay. Let's go.
Actual counter on that fucker.
Yeah. And if damage would be dealt to Undergrowth Champion,
remove one.
It has, remove a +1/+1 counter to prevent all damage.
Yeah, so as long as it keeps growing, he can keep preventing damage, so you gotta kill that thing.
Oh, okay.
That's okay, you got stuff. You're playing red, so. Is that it, Jake?
Yeah, that was it.
Alright, so you get to take your turn there, Kate. Untap and draw. Not bad.
Okay.
Play it and read it aloud.
Okay. Browbeat?
Browbeat.
Oh, shit. It
means to stare at someone with, like, an angry
face. Yeah. What is it? They can draw?
She's going to draw 3 cards if you don't take 5 damage. And she's playing red deck wins.
Yeah, I'll take 5 damage.
All right. So you take damage from a sorcery.
Yeah.
All right. So now she gets to deal 5 damage to a creature you control.
5 damage to a creature that I control?
That he controls because of your centaur or your satyr.
Oh.
Yeah, so smack that guy.
I'll just remove the counter and he lives.
That's it.
And that's a go.
But if you wouldn't have, you would have drawn 3 more cards, and he does not want you drawing cards.
Yeah.
You don't need more lands. I've been reading the cards that are in my hand, and they're...
And I'll equip it to
him. Oh, nice. Okay. Yeah. Get him ready.
Okay. And let's go.
So you stopped him. He couldn't smash you because you got rid of that fucking counter. Alright, that's good. That's something you can use right now. So you get a gutter snipe out there.
Let's go.
Always read them aloud. That way you can, you know, too.
Oh, yeah, that's true.
I don't know how many times I forget what a creature does just because I play it and don't...
Landfall.
You know, make a mental note. There's that counter back. At least it's only a little bit bigger now, right?
Mm-hmm.
Swing?
I'm gonna swing.
Okay, well, you got your Phoenix to block with. You know it can come back.
And so. Put a land in my hand.
Okay.
To give it +2/+2, so it's a 5/5 right now.
Is he trample?
No, he's not.
Okay, so you can block him with your Phoenix.
Yeah.
As long as you get an instant or sorcery spell to hit him, you can bring your Phoenix back later.
Okay.
which is probably a high possibility. Mm-hmm. All right, so block with the phoenix, and phoenix is graved. Poor little phoenix, killing birds, Jake.
What's your deal?
Just an innocent little bird. Dumbledore's going to be mad at you.
Right. Super mad.
Okay.
Alright. Well, let's see what you got going on here. Hmm. Just wait for it. Sicko. Yeah. It's not much you can do. You need that one land.
Yeah.
Forest attack, put a land back in my hand.
Okay,
give it plus 2/2.
Okay,
so it's 5/5 again.
Yep, that's it.
Are you gonna take it or are you gonna block?
Take it.
Oh no, block with a gutter snipe. Because he can pump things. Yeah, you don't want him pumping on you.
Okay. Okay, so, yeah,
number four.
Gutter
snipe block.
Okay.
Okay, so he just dies.
And I'll play, after combat, I'll play Searing Blaze. So, because that'll enter the battlefield this turn. It will deal 3 damage to you and 3 damage to this creature.
Oh, that's brutal. Yeah. Hold on. Mm-hmm. Tap 3.
Okay.
We'll play the guy in your hand that costs 3 that has flash.
Is this one?
Yeah, read it.
When dual caster mage enters the battlefield, copy target instant or sorcery spell. You may choose new targets for that copy.
So you get to copy this spell.
Mm-hmm.
You didn't have a land in or play this turn, but you get to deal 1 damage to him and just zap one of his creatures for 1. It won't do anything to the creature, but he has to remove a counter.
Yeah. Yep. So that and
1 to you.
Mm-hmm.
So your satyr dies, but now you have another guy on the field.
Mm-hmm.
And that's a go.
You get a mana screw hardy if you need that mana.
Yeah. Yeah.
There it is. What you got here? Oh, this counter's gone, by the way.
No, I didn't remove it. It's my choice.
Is it your choice to remove? What is
yeah.
this?
Yeah. If damage should be dealt to Undergrowth Champion while it has a +1 counter, prevent that damage and remove a +1 counter from Undergrowth Champion.
You must.
Oh, you must?
Yes. It says remove it. Prevent it. So now's your chance. This.
So.
You see, this thing's not killing you right now.
Mm-hmm.
This thing is.
Yeah.
Fated Conflagration.
Mm-hmm.
5 damage to your creature or planeswalker, and if it's your turn, scry 2. So put your hand down and look at 2 there and see if you like those. That can go to the bottom, you don't need that.
Yeah.
Save it, or are you gonna let it go?
Pardon?
She did Flated Configuration to that.
Oh, thing. Sorry, I didn't even hear that at all.
5 damage to it.
Yeah.
Yeah, good.
It's fine.
At least you got rid of one there, that's good.
Mm-hmm. Let's go.
Intently reading that hand, eh?
No, like, I quite literally... I heard everything else. I heard you talking. I did not hear a word from Kate.
No, she played it down and everything.
Yeah, didn't even phase me.
Yeah. Jake was in a land. That's awesome.
Tough one, Scoop Mob.
Oh, a Scoop Mob. Those things are dirty.
Sath Leopard.
Oh my god, what the heck? What's happening?
And let's go.
Ah! things, Kate!
Lots of things.
Side landfall.
Yep. True. Mm-hmm. Alright. What you got here? Put him down for now. Actually, no. Say go.
Go.
Yeah.
Landfall. Oh, that's 2-2.
Jake is allergic to landfall.
Yep.
I'll play Mina and Den.
Oh, jeez.
Two.
You're still at 20, so don't worry. You can still take some hits.
Mm-hmm. Seagull.
Alright, what do you got here? Nice.
Alright.
I would actually say go again. You're on the react. If he does something, you need to do stuff, so.
Yeah. Go.
That's your upkeep. Don't forget that, Jake. These are lenient games, so I'm letting him. Normally, I don't let him do this stuff. He's experienced enough.
All right. Play land. I'll attack.
Full attack, eh?
Yeah.
Okay, so what's this?
One second. So I'm going to return a land to my hand here. So give it plus 2/2. So it's an 11/11. That's a 5/5 right now. That's a 2/2.
Okay, so put that in front of that, obviously, right?
Yeah.
And then he's going to react over here.
Yeah. And they'll play Swell of Growth.
2/2.
Growth Champion.
So he's hitting for 7.
Play another land.
8. Alright. And he's hitting for 3. So that's 11. Yeah. Now you're going to be taking, put you to 9. Now you play this. Impact Residence.
X damage divided as you choose among any number of target creatures, where X is the greatest amount of damage dealt by a source to a permanent or player this turn. So this thing died, and it received 11 damage. So now, tap 3. Copy that spell.
Oh.
22 damage divided as you choose, so that's all going to be gone.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. And she can't divide it to players, but she can get dealt by a source or permanent player. Right? Yeah, of target creatures. So yeah, she can only hit your creatures, so
yeah,
we're definitely all going to die. Mm-hmm.
That's cool.
Yeah. And there's ways to even double what this does in here. Like, you'll deal the 10 and then it happens again, yeah, and then you copy it and it happens again.
Nice.
So with red deck wins, you kind of got to really play it out well. Like, you got to wait on your... You got to wait it out for certain turns.
You got to hold.
For certain,
you
gotta it doesn't matter if you take damage when you're playing red deck.
You let him empty his hand thinking, oh no, oh no. He's got one card left and he's playing landfall. That's not good.
No, it's not. That's not even a card that helps me out.
Go.
That was your attack.
Yeah, that was right after my attack. So
that's your turn now.
Hold on, actually. Wait,
he's got something he can play.
There we go. Seriously, that doesn't help me now.
All right, so now you get to be red. Now you get to start to be red. Draw your shit. What you got? That's what you want. So what you got in your hand here? You want this out. Okay. Yep. Heartless Aizaku.
Yeah.
And then you attack with your little guy.
Oh, those two.
Yeah. That's good.
Let's go.
One tap. Draw your card. She played it well.
She did.
Try to play your land. What do you got? Okay, so what you're going to do is you're going to Heartless Aizaku. Tap him.
Okay.
Now read what he does.
When it attacks, deals that much damage equal to half.
But when he taps.
Oh.
So he just says tap. Mm-hmm. So you just tap him. Yep, deals damage to each player equal to half that player's life total rounded down. So your life total will be 8 rounded down. You will take 4 damage. You will go to 5. His life total is 12. Now, he will take 6 damage. That will bring him to 6. Mm-hmm. Now, play this card.
I just realized what my biggest mistake there was.
Furnace of Wrath.
Yeah.
She declares attack with this guy. You take 4 damage. Yeah. Puts you to 2. So you go.
Go.
God damn, I better have something with haste. Nope. That's game.
Extend the hand. That's a good one.
Yep. Yeah.
Good game.
I thought you really had me there.
No, I was a retard and didn't use fucking Mina and Den's ability.